Dr. Thigpen, what does it mean to be made in the image of God?
This is something that we've wrestled with forever, I think, to really understand. To think about, what does it mean? What is it? What part of God's image have I been made in? Because God is so large and so immense, it's really hard to boil that down. But when we look at the way that Genesis talks about this, it really seems to say two primary things. One is that we were created to be connected to Him, and that we were created to be reflective of Him. So in this way, we might say that we're connected to Him the same way that a daughter or a son is connected to their parent. They're a chip off the old block. They are born in the image of their parents. And so we have that strong connection for Him. But we also have the sense in which we are meant to reflect Him in the world. And it's the idea that the same way that a crown prince or a crown princess might go out and represent the reign of the great king, we go out into the world and we represent Him to the world. You might say it even as provocatively as this, that the only authorized image of God in the world is humanity. It's not idolatry. It's not something that we might create, but it's us who He's created. The reason that we're authorized is because He's the one who made us. He was able to choose what it is that we're in His image. So, but there are a number of things that come with this that we don't oftentimes think of. We're usually trying to think of, am I made in the image because I can communicate? Am I made in the image because I'm rational? Am I made in the image because I can do certain things? But that's really not what the emphasis is on. The emphasis is on relationship, both to Him and to the world. But that means something very unique when we look at the way this language is used in Genesis 1, because it's not just me. I'm not the only one who was created in the image of God. We, as humanity, were created in the image of God. So it means at a very practical level that if I acknowledge my own creation in the image of God, I am obligated to acknowledge yours. That means that with everything related to justice and related to goodness in the world, it means that we are to function communally and cooperatively, not just me with God, but it's me with God with you, because He's created humanity as an entity that cooperates together. Just as Adam and Eve were created together, they were created in the image of God. Male and female, together He created humanity in the image of God. So now when I look around the world, we have all been created in the image of God. And so we all must cooperate and we must flourish together, or we must perish together, because God's designed humanity to operate cooperatively, to be connected to Him and reflective of Him in the world. Now, we walk through that in the Old Testament, but it doesn't stop there, because then we come to the coming of Jesus. And Jesus shows up as the image of God, but not the way that I am. I'm not purely reflective of who God is, and there's distance between me and God because of my sin. But Jesus comes as the perfect express image of God. And so now I am being conformed into His image, transformed slowly, degree by degree, as His Spirit works in me and He works among us as a community, to be transformed even more into the image of His Son, who is the express image of God. So when I think about what it means to be made in the image of God, it is value for every human. It is the image of God that gives each one worth. But it's also the image of God that gives us together worth. And to the extent if I push any of His image bearers away, I've rejected part of what it means for me to be made in His image. But I've also been not left with, let's look at each other and figure out what it means. I've been left with the image of Christ, His divine Son. That is what God looks like. That is who He is. That's how He reveals Himself. So now I know what that image should look like in me, because I can follow His Son and I can step in His footsteps and walk after Him. And we as the church can do the same and walk in the manner that He's called us to walk in. That's what it means to be made in the image of God, to be connected to Him and reflective of Him in the world.